Out to give half her fortune to charity. She is the ex-wife of Amazon founder and CEO Jeff Bezos. Just a little more than a month after the pair finalized their divorce, Mackenzie signed the Giving Pledge. The Giving Pledge was started in 2010. Now, when you think about dating, often you think about 20 or 30 somethings looking for love. But did you know singles over the age of 50 are actually the fastest growing group of online daters? And they are also the largest segment of daters at Chicago's Smart Dating Academy. And that is where our Bela Gandhi comes in. Welcome back, Bella. Always good to have you.
Good to be here.
That's an interesting figure that they are the largest group. What's going on with singles over 50?
So let me tell you about singles. There's 110 million single adults in this country. 5 million of them are over 50. So it is a fast growing population. Lots of them, the kids have just left. They realize they haven't been in a good marriage and they're like, okay, last kid's gone, game over. I want to be single again. So that's what's happening across the nation.
Interesting. Very interesting. So what's the chance that singles over 50 can actually find love again? So, you know, we've been talking to some of the other people who had said, it's really hard when you're over 50.
Look, it's really hard when you're 20, 30, or 40 as well. So there's no difference when you're over 50. No, but and it's possible, but it takes diligence. It takes positivity and patience to do it. You can't just decide, well, I want to find someone and try it for 7 days and say, well, love isn't meant for me if that's the case. You have to have the right mindset to go into
this. Okay, so with the right mindset, what do you tell your singles over 50? What websites or apps do you send them to? Not that we're endorsing anybody, but if people are watching this and they want to know, what do you usually tell them to do? Where do you usually tell them to go?
Well, I tend to like sites that have bigger denominators. Okay, so large apps like Match or eHarmony, even Tinder and Bumble have produced couplings and marriages for people over 50.
Okay, so you say, and you say definitely do that because it does make it a lot easier.
Yeah,
because it's still a turnoff to a lot of people to think about that, especially at this stage, because, you know, for the younger set, that's the world of dating, but not so much for the older, right?
And nobody comes to me, not one person over the thousands of people we've had over the last decade that has said, I'm so excited about online dating. It's a necessary means to an end. One in three couples in this place met because of an online dating connection. If you're not doing it, think about it. Do you want to be out at the bars three, four nights a week, hooping it up or going to fundraisers all the time? No. When you're at home, I'm not saying online dating is awesome, but I'm saying you can look through photos, you can read what someone wrote about themselves and say, yeah, you know what? That person seems like the caliber of someone I'd want to be with, and then say yes.
Okay. So a couple more questions for you then. So I've heard this often with girlfriends who say men over 50 don't want to date women 50 and over. They want to go younger. Do you find that to be true?
Not always. Look, there are those men, and that's fine. Let's just not worry about those men if you're a woman over 50. There are plenty of men that are looking for age-appropriate partners, right? That's the majority of men that I've come across. We work with a lot of men in our practice as well, and they want age-appropriate women, right? The guys that are looking for, you know, someone 20, 30 years younger, they're not coming to me. They're going to Tinder and swiping right on everybody.
Okay, very good to know. Now, what about people who say, you know what, I've done what you've said to do, and nobody's emailing me back or contacting me back. What's wrong?
Well, there could be a lot of things. It could be a perfect storm. It could be the quality of your photos. Do they look as good as you do in real life? Is it the text? Is it the messaging that you're doing? Or are you messaging the wrong people? A lot of people kind of stray way out of their own sandbox, right? If I'm going to, you know, if I was single and said, oh, George Clooney's single, what are my odds of getting an email back from him? Probably pretty low. I'm a mere mortal,
so be realistic.
Be realistic in who you're looking for. Be the person that you want to attract.
Okay, I like that. Very nice. Okay, here's the next big question. So, is it true that there is a three-date rule when it comes to getting intimate?
Yes. No, of course there's not a three-date rule. I don't know who invented that rule, but they're a genius.
Well, because you don't want to look like you're easy, let's be honest, right?
No, there is no three-date rule. Exactly. There is no rule except you make the rules. Now, if I'm your dating coach, I'm going to tell you, don't shack up and, you know, do that with someone until you are in a committed, exclusive relationship because of 100 reasons that I'm happy to talk to you about later
offline. Camera, huh?
Exactly.
Okay, so, yeah, so don't do it. So then yours could be a 20-date rule for all I know then.
It is 12 to 20. I call it sexclusivity. Don't have sex until you're in an exclusive relationship.
12 to 20 dates.
It's a lot, but it's not really a lot. If you go on a date a week with someone and then maybe 2 or 3 weeks later, 2 dates and then 3 dates, it quickly adds up to 12 to 20. So follow these rules if you're single.
And if you didn't get it all in, what website do we need to go to?
SmartDatingAcademy.com.
Very good.
Follow us on Instagram at SmartDatingAcademy.
Oh, I love it. Thanks so much. Always good advice. We appreciate you coming in.
Thanks.
Very interesting. Coming up, Master